around. I'm talking about in the entertainment field. Ooh, Mr. James Brown and Miss Gladys Knight. Both James and Gladys are very, very active.
He's a heavyweight.
Oh, the top. It's
all right. Well, I weight, I mean in heavy heaven.
Oh, yeah. You know, you don't need no diet, James. Everything's cool with you.
No, man. I have no problems here, man. Believe me. I don't know. I guess
James, you and Gladys both are very active in community affairs. I know myself, from watching you and reading about you, you're active in the Big Brothers. You have this drug thing going. You also have this stay in school and this respect for the black youth. Gladys, you yourself, you have this sickle cell anemia thing going. How can you rap to us about that a little bit?
Well, we're doing a show on the 28th for the sickle cell. It's like a telethon and to raise money to combat the disease, you know.
Great.
And we really feel like we've been involved in so many things, like helping congressmen and doing everything, you know. And we, the only way we feel like we can really help, other than going in our pockets, mm-hmm. is to donate our talents,
great.
You know, and that's what we're doing, you know, at this particular program.
It's really a great effort. I'm sure it's something that's well worth the effort that people really appreciate, and something that, you know, came on and something we have to conquer and get settled right away.
That's
right.
I was
wondering if any of the fans have anything to say about it. Will they want to ask the question or... something you all would like to know that Gladys might be able to help you with. Anyone? Don't be afraid.
You want to rap?
Well, y'all just send your contributions.
Would you like to use my mic?
Because
he can use my mic. Would you like to ask something?
You said that she was starting this thing on sickle cell anemia. Could you explain that a little bit? You know, because I ain't aware.
Well, it's going to be a telethon, you know, like they have for muscular dystrophy and so many other diseases, you know, cancer things, to raise money to for research to help to find out, you know, what can be a cure for the disease. And they're going to put on a telethon to help to raise the money. And we're going to help them with our talents, you know, by performing and whatever else we can do in that line to help raise the money. So, you know, we're...
That's real help. You know,
my man.
You know, you don't really understand what it's, you know, like if a disease, there's a disease, you can't really get the significance of it unless it hits home,
yes.
You know. And that's when we don't need it. So let's try to take care of it now before it gets home. You know?
Yeah. Yeah, right on. Yeah.
Yeah.
James,
I want to allow for the cat to drop the top or something like that. I think he just needs some blood. It's a little weak, but everything is groovy. That's one of the cameramen. Isn't that what you want
to
ask me?
Yeah, Mr. Brown, I'd like to...
Hey, man, I'm going to that. I thought we got that straight this time.
All right, we got James.
I'm young
so
as
I
am,
by the you want I keep calling him
I'm
Mr.
Call
Brown.
You mister.
Could you
because you're my elder, you know. Why not? I'm sorry, what you say?
I'd like for you to elaborate a little bit on what you've been into. I know it's probably
know.
Take all the show to find out what you've been into.
No, I don't know. I guess I'm deep into this drug thing because I know the drug is like a thing that it takes its own, man. It's really a conqueror. It's a Hitler in a bottle or a pill jar, what have you. You know, it's a thing that we got to really stamp out now because we need to be able to. Control our own destiny, and you can't control your own destiny when you're overpowered by something that's much more stronger, you know?
Right, right on. Definitely so, yeah.
But if anybody, you know, anybody want to rap a little bit about it, tell me, yes.
Have you any success?
Well, we feel that success is the motivation, you know, inspire people and motivate them into doing things about it and make kids really getting together and having rap sessions or what have you. And then we gave money, but we find that the methadone programs are just basically a time buyer, something to buy time to give people a chance to make up their mind. Because it's really, when I say revolution of the mind, it's basically everything's that way. You know, it's revolution right here. Can you get it together? In order for me to deal with the country, I've got to get me together. So we try to get people, we're trying to inspire them and motivate them into organizing me, who is most important to all of us. You see?
James, we have a question back here, this young lady.
Yes. Excuse me, cameras. She warned me before. Yes?
I would like to know that you say that, you know, drugs is wrong, but do you feel that you can get, I mean, you can make a young teenager change over their man before their own parents can?
Well, it's a funny thing, you know. I'm glad you asked that because I got a problem with my kid, you know. And it seems the cat next door can always rap a little bit better, you dig? Because it feels that he's, well, you know, kids are there in the form of, like I came through the same thing. Well, you know, you really want to rebel a little bit, and but you deep inside, you love them, but you hate to admit it, you know. And the person next door, you always open up with them and say, well, all right, bang, bang, bang. But I think the kids will, like, dig my reputation, my record, what I've been doing, and where I came from, my humble beginning, the ghetto, you know, and, like, the fact that I was a juvenile delinquent, made time, that I really know the inside out of it. And I'd like to save any kid from going through what we've gone through, because it's too much to be done, you know, the skyscrapers and the big buildings that's not owned by the minorities or the people, or the poor people or the blacks or what have you. And if we can get them together and show them the same, bro, this is a revolution, the thing that you've been preaching, go on and get your education together, get your mind together, so, like, you can control these things, you understand? Because brothers have been known to get to be able to earn money, but they can't keep it because we need specialties and expertise. So that's one reason I think that they'll stay with me.
Yeah. James, what about the school dropouts? That's another real heavy thing that you...
Well, man, that's always my pet program. I say there's no room for ignorance, and it's kind of heavy. I think the cat is telling me to get back over. Anything else, Dan?
No, that's all.
You out of sight. I'll tell you that. Excuse me, bro. No swearing. I'm together. Me and you. My man. Yes, sir.
As far as the school dropouts, you had this record, Stay in School, which you donated the royalties to this purpose, which was... big act, as far as I'm concerned, and also this record you have about King Harlan. You're devoting the royalties of that to fight this problem in our country, which is a great thing.
Well, thank you very much. Well, I feel that that's one of the many things that we need to do, and like Sister was talking now earlier, it's a thing where not only she and I and her group, but I feel that all of us who are in tune and we know what it's about, I mean, like, we're from there and we shouldn't forget so quick and become unfamiliarized with what's going on when we know the problem and we know it better than the people that we're trying to relate to. It's hard to find a congressman or senator or a president that knows it as well, and they can only go by what we tell them. So it's up to us to tell them, you know, because they could do a much better job if they were in tune. And I think by people like Elder Miss Glad and I and Pips and myself, I think we can really get it across and inspire a lot of other entertainers, ball players and what have you, to get
right,
into the set.
Great.
Look, don't let me talk too long. I wrapped
up. Oh, no, everything's beautiful. Speaking of drugs and our problems in this country today, if they all were cured, we all could make it through the night, which brings up Gladys's next tune, Help Me Make It Through the Night.
Beautiful, beautiful.
I'm imagining a lot of happy people. And most of you are with someone you love. Well, you are the lucky ones. All over the world, there are lots of people who are alone tonight. I imagine most of us have been in that situation at some time or another. I know I have. Recently, I heard a most beautiful song with a dynamic lyric that really expresses this feeling of loneliness. It means a lot to me personally, and I'd like to share it with you. I think you'll see what I mean. Take the ribbon from my hair. Shake it loose and let it fall. Laying soft against your skin. Like the shadows on the wall. Come and lay down by my side. Get tomorrow's out of sight. And it's so sad to be alone. Help me make it through the night.
Right on. Fantastic. Gladys Knight, ladies and gentlemen. Right now. We're still. Be right back. Be right back. Stay with us, Soul Street Gang. Be right back. Short break.
We're gonna take a little pause for the cause, so hold on, children. We'll be right back.
Well, like you said, that.